Hello, I am Gapwin. This is Planet Explorers, creation mode, etc. Today we're going to be building a sword, and I was thinking a lot about what kind of thing I wanted to build. I haven't done one of these in a while. Planet Explorers just had the 0.85 update on Steam, and I really wanted to hop in and start making some more videos. And since a lot of people have recently been commenting on liking my Star Destroyer, I figured, hey, let's keep the Star Wars thing going. We'll do a quicker video today. I'm gonna make the new lightsaber from the Force Awakens trailer. Now, I know there's been a lot of debate on that lightsaber. Personally, I'm still kind of mixed on it. You know, I appreciate that they are trying to do some different stuff and experiment a little bit, but I also am fairly attached to the old aesthetic. I mean, I admit some of that's just nostalgia on my part, but I still like the original Star Wars aesthetic, and I like that they're kind of going back to it, but I appreciate that they want to experiment and do something new, so I'm still out on it. I think that kind of sums up my expectations of the new movie. Is it doesn't quite look like the original Star Wars anymore, but maybe the innovation will be good. And that's kind of how I feel about this new lightsaber. You know, it looks a little silly on first glance, but maybe they'll do something neat with it in action. Alright, lightsaber, going to be a little bit more of a simple build. I only gave myself 5 of a buffer down here, because I might want to do a little bit with this, but the new lightsaber has a mildly shorter handle than most. At least from what it looks like. Either that or the guy has bigger hands. Most lightsabers kind of fall into the hand and a half style sword, where it's primarily, you know, used as a one-handed weapon, but has enough space for two hands. This one, it looks a little bit short to be used with two hands very easily, so I'm going to try to, you know, keep that. Now, the lightsaber is going to be pretty simple itself. I'm going to make the blade out of aluminum. It's not going to do a lot of damage. Actually, let's make the blade out of diamond. Why not? We got diamond. It's going to be pretty simple to build. All right, because it's just several tubes, basically. And unfortunately, the game doesn't give us quite enough granularity. Let's make it slightly longer, since it's kind of a, you know, claymore-y style. Let's make it a little longer than you'd think. It might look a little ridiculous. Unfortunately, the creation editor does not give you a huge amount of granularity that you can use with swords, so we're gonna make a 2x2 cylinder, and then we'll put a 2x2 point on it. There you go, that tapers out. And we're going to color it using decals. I'm just using diamonds because, as you can see, this thing's gonna do no damage at all. Yeah, currently attack 96, which is, I believe, worse than your starter wood sword. But we know you're never gonna make a lightsaber that does good damage. And you're just not, unless you are doing this, what I consider mildly cheaty. Nothing wrong with it if you want to do it in your builds to make your aesthetic swords do more damage, but you can, like, hide phantom blades around the edges that are barely visible. I personally don't like doing that. Not for any kind of, like, cheaty reason, it just, I feel it messes with the aesthetic slightly. So there's our main blade, which, we'll see if it winds up being short or not. We're going to color it later. We also want to make our handle, which is where most of our detail is going to be. Unfortunately, like I said, you can't get a huge amount of granularity. We're going to go with steel for the handle. And we'll start with a with another 2x2 cylinder, like that. So that's our basic shape, and we're going to try to expand on it and get as much detail as we can, though. You know, varying degrees. We definitely don't want to see this hilt, so we'll go into the inspector, model visible, and have an invisible handle. And there it is. There's our stick. Lightsaber stick. Pretty nice. Pretty awesome, yeah. Our glow stick of doom. Doom glow stick. Alright, now let's get up here and add that controversial crossbar. I want to make it the same both sides, so we're going to turn on our, not x-axis, we're going to turn on our z-axis mirroring. Just to make sure, because this x-axis is the front of our sword, if you click on that there. We want our z-axis mirrored. Gonna go into our materials, grab our steel again. This one's slightly different. We want it to be Let's start one space. That was weird. I feel like my teeth buzzed. Let's put this at 22. Yeah, let's turn the laser grid for this so I can see what I'm doing a little better. 22. I wish you could type in Y values on this thing. There we go, 22. This is gonna be a little weird. We'll go out, let's call it 4. 5, 4. We'll call it 4. We'll go up one and hit tab to reorient our cylinder. There we go. Then while we have the cylinder tool ready, we'll make the crossbar blade. We'll bring it out, let's say, that far? Yeah, well, a little shorter because we need to add the point. There we go. Now, once again, we add our cone. This one's a bit weird. You have to do the cone on this side because the cone, as you can see, will only align in these three ways. So either straight up, going towards your x-axis, or going towards your z-axis. So if you want it to point the other way, you have to mirror it like we're doing here. So we'll do out to 3 and like that, just to taper the edges off a little bit. Give it as much of that lightsaber feel as we can. All right, now the rest of it is going to be trying to add a little bit of detail. Let's turn the Z mirroring off for right now. Now there's two major bits to this. One, the bottom has a slight, come on bottom. There's the very bottom. Yeah, we'll start there. The bottom definitely has a slightly larger bit. So we will make a, this is a 2x2. So let's make a 3x3 rectangle around it. That's 3x4. We have to do a 4x4, don't we? Yeah, we'll make a 4x4 rectangle, not rectangle, cylinder around, goes up slightly to just below where your character's hand will be. There we go. Why are my steels different colors? I really don't know. That looks a little bit ridiculous. Just a teeny bit. Let's see if we can make that any smaller. Let's see if we start in a little bit. I don't think I can get a 3x3 in there. I think it has to be a 4x4. Yeah, it has to be a 4x4, but we'll make it a little shorter just to counteract some of the ridiculous lookingness of this, and then we'll cut down on the bottom slightly. Let's turn our Z mirroring back on. Let's see what happens when we start cutting away at the bottom slightly. See if we can get a little bit of a better shape going here. Now I should have done the quad mirroring. I'll do that now. Not Y, it's X. X and Z mirrored just to make sure we keep everything as even as we can. Let's select these two. Now Shift. No, we can't do it with two. Select one, see if we can move the voxel in a little bit with our manual voxel editing. Yeah, that'll help. Thankfully, the voxel editing also mirrors, so we don't have to do it on every side. No, not that one. This guy. Let's take that way down. Maybe a little bit pointy. Still feel like the whole thing's a little chunky. Let's take off these sides here. These invisible blocks that are holding it out a bit. Mildly chunky, but not quite as bad. Also, this bit will be covered by your hand. Next, there's this kind of extra guard bit under here. We'll turn our mirroring off. Bring it up. There's this other cylinder that goes underneath this. We're going to try and replicate it. We have to use another 4x4, and we'll see how ridiculous it starts looking. We're gonna have to take a lot of this away. Definitely turn back on Z mirroring so that it is even. Start removing these parts. No, not those parts. Well, maybe one of those. Move one of those parts and one of these. Good. We need to remove pretty much everything from the side because it's sort of a shield looking thing that only affects the side. Unfortunately, I should have also turned on X-mirroring. There we go. So we shall remove everything from this side until it's back down into the middle. Yeah, like that. We can remove these to give it a little bit more of a tapered shape. Let's not remove those, but let's take these voxels way down. Make sure the shape's as tapered as we can get. Maybe taper these very slightly on the inside. Let's see. Let's see how that's looking. Yeah, not terrible, but I don't like it. Let's see if we can taper these a little bit, make it look slightly more rounded instead of that sheer cutoff we're getting. All right, a little better. A little better. We're never going to get quite the granularity that we want. Can we up this voxel? Yeah, we'll up these two because it kind of goes around and cups the sidebar blades. All right, this isn't going to look as detailed as I'd like, unfortunately, just because of the limitations you're dealing with here. Let's up these voxels. Now down this one slightly. Come on. All right, not terrible. There would be a lot more detail in here. I do wish you could get finer detail going in here. Now, let me see if I can give it this a little bit of a pinch on this part, because in the screen caps that I've been using, the blade is slightly, the thing is slightly pinched in here. Gives it a slightly closer look, and then this should be actually a little more flush. So if I can flush this out a little bit, come on, take it down. Looks ridiculous up close, but when you're farther away, it kind of makes it look a little more lightsabery. Actually, I feel. You can feel free to disagree with me. I know this is going to be a quicker video. I do kind of apologize for that, because this thing, just not as detailed as it could be. I'll do something a little more detailed soon. I have an idea. I found a neat-looking kind of Gundam sword. If you have a sword that you want me to look at, I don't feel my skills are quite up to the replica. Like, I don't claim that I could take, like, your favorite weapon and make an exact replica, but I could definitely do something inspired by it. Do kind of my own style, take on the style. Let's move some of these in a little bit, give it a bit of texture down there, and maybe make these taper off a bit more so that it doesn't look quite as weird and clunky. You have to zoom out. Remember, you're looking at it a lot closer than you will ever see it. That's looking pretty good. I don't hate it. I feel like if I try to get too much more detail in here, we're going to wind up with a minor problem, because you just can't get that detailed in the creation editor. All right, now we're going to paint the thing. I've got two things I'm going to do. Let's hide the window. We'll keep the mirroring on for now, just to make it easier. We're going to paint. Let's just get a black, and let's get a black, and I should be able to turn down the opacity on this somewhere, I think. Paint, brush strength way down. So I want it to have sort of a, I still want it to look a little like the steel, but have a very dark tint. I don't want it to be a matte black, but I want it to be tinted a lot. And I can go over the diamond slightly, because I'm going to use a decal on the diamond so that it glows. Alright, let's... come on, get that bit. It's got a couple of weird protrusions there that won't paint. Come on. Paint. Paint. Paint, paint, paint. Paint. Why won't you paint, you thing? Let's try disabling our mirroring. Maybe that's giving us a problem. Paint. Turn up our brush radius. Okay, those bits won't go. That's a bit weird. We'll look at it from this side. Then. Eh, some of the flaws look a little ugly. But out, when it's actually far enough away that you would be looking at it, doesn't look bad. Does not look bad. Out of curiosity, let's put the decals on. I made a red decal. I use these rounded rectangles for almost everything. Turn on Z mirroring to make it easier to place. Place two on there. Turn off Z mirroring. Place like one here. Good for right now. Go into parts so we can edit the decals. These need to be rotated a bit to about 90. Good, and then moved. Oh, oops. Undo. Redo. Turn your Z mirroring back on so that I can move both of these at once. Rotate it to 90. Then move it in slightly and over slightly so it covers the entire thing. There, now we've got a red blade made of diamonds, which is very good because lightsabers obviously have the whatchamacallit made up word crystal. I'm gonna lose my Star Wars fan card there, aren't I? Alright, we take that. We should be able to paste this or copy this somehow. Maybe not. Yeah, maybe not. I thought I could copy these somehow, but it does not appear to be the case, or I forgot how to do it. So, sorry for that. I definitely want emission on all selected on all these. I'm gonna make this one slightly bigger. Well, I don't know. 0.5. Apply. No, too big. 0.3. And apply, I guess we'll just do 0.2. Double the size. And apply, and move it up. Then we're gonna have to just repeat that. Going up. Decals. This one. Still can't believe I can't copy-paste that. Oh, well, my fault. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5-ish. Alright, let's just put a couple more on here. 3, we'll call it 4, and then if we don't need the last one. Now the reason I'm doing that, I'll explain in a minute. So, I don't want, hang on, parts. I don't want to make it too huge. Let's make this 0.2 again. I don't want to make the box too huge, because when you're in-game, anything that the box intersects is also going to get that kind of red glowy line on it. So while you could just make a huge frickin' box that would, you know, cover this whole thing, it would also extend itself a little too wide. So I'd rather just tile it up than have the, you know, wide box that will hit our shield or character or ground when we have this thing. And then 0.2 again, apply, no, 0.2 and apply, 0.2 and apply, I don't know why this is off center, come over here to cover more, and up, can we get all of it? No, we need this tiny one, but the tiny one can stay tiny. And on the just covering the top, so that we don't get that ring around things. And there, that's pretty much it. Oh, those lines are gonna show up, aren't they? Can I make those cover them? I hadn't actually tried that method before. Can I make these lines not show up? Nope, the lines are gonna show up. So you get lines either way, unfortunately. I think I'd rather have these on the emitters than have that line hitting everything. I can show you the version that I tested these with for the line. But all in all, this is pretty done. We'll turn off our mirroring and we'll show you the final saber here. It's grab screenshots for the heck of it. Now we'll save this and export it and get it into our character to show it off in the game world. Make it a darker screen there. Zoom in. There, let's get that nice picture of the ridiculous hilt looking thing there. And we'll call this New Saver. Why not? Save. Alrighty then, we're gonna jump into the game and see what this looks like on a character. All right, now you can see here's the shield that I made last go. Still not colored right for some reason. And this is a test version of the sword that I did. And as you can see, it's got this problem where this big line is intersecting the shield, where the decal goes, which is a problem that hopefully our new version, I did this really quick just to test out a concept I had, but our slightly more refined version should fix that. Ooh, did I forget to? I forgot to export it, didn't I? Oh well, ISO, sword, new saber, export to character. There we are. Now we can use the thing. There it is. There, now you see it does give it a little bit of an intersect, but not as much as the other one, which is good. Let's take off that shield. It looks ridiculous. There we have the new lightsaber. A little shorter than I thought it would come out. So you can decide if you like these tiny lines or if you'd rather have the thing intersect stuff. All in all, not a bad build, I do feel. Just in time for some arguments about whether or not you like the new Star Wars trailer. Oh well, if you want some old school Star Wars, I did that Star Destroyer build that should have been linked in the beginning. Attack of 94, so not going to do any real damage with the thing. But remember, it is a more elegant weapon. So, you don't need to do a huge amount of damage. There we go, I hope you've enjoyed. You can subscribe if you want to see more Planet Explorers. I'm planning on doing a few more build videos and some other things. Oh, and look at this awesome land bridge that I spawned next to, which is fun with the new way that things generate terrain. Just thought I'd point that out. Anyway, yes, if you want to see more Planet Explorers, random tutorials, a couple of Let's Play series, you can subscribe to my channel. I kind of do whatever I find enjoyable at the time. If you just enjoyed this video, you can leave a like. I'm Gaplin, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon.